General Motors has the largest General Motors factory in Europe producing opals in Aragon, Spain. 500,000 opals a year. So a couple of years ago, I was with the local CEO and I said, nice roof. He's got a nice roof on that factory. He said, what? I said, that roof is a power plant. So this fall, Carl Peter Forstner, the head of GM Europe, he leased out the roof of that factory to Veolia, a French company, in Clairvoyant. He leased it. They put a $78 million photovoltaic utility on that roof. And listen to this. It creates 10 megawatts of electricity. What does that mean? That is enough electricity for one roof to power 4,700 homes, one roof. Think of all the roofs in Sicily, big roofs, factories. They pay that 9 years, then it's all free. You just maintain the building. Let's stay in Aragon, Spain. Aragon and Navarra, Spain, have been in a war with each other, a good war. They're neighboring provinces. In 10 years, both of these regions have gone to 70% renewable energy. In Aragon, the premier that took me on a drive in his car out into a beautiful valley nestled in the Pyrenees. And he said, Mr. Rifkin, look up there in the distance. What do you see? And I said, I see some buildings. He said, look closer. As we got closer, I saw the 21st century. It was a technology park. Already people in the park, Microsoft, other companies. These beautiful glass buildings with diagonal roofs like you see in science fiction movies. 12 buildings up, 40 slated for production, and here's what these buildings operate on. There are wind turbines across the Pyrenees for wind. They take the snow from the mountains for hydroelectricity. They have solar collectors across the valley following the sun. This park is 80% off-grid. In a year from now, 100% off-grid. In a year and a half from now, they create more power than they need. They are a power plant, not just a technology park. Right now, no help from Madrid, no help from Brussels. Bouygues, I don't know if you know Bouygues, it's the second largest construction company. It's a French company. Olivier Bouygues sat me down last spring and he showed me the office plans for a building going up in Paris right now this year. This building is architecturally incredible. It's all designed to collect the energy around the building. In this case, just sun. It doesn't even do wind or heat. It creates more power than it needs when it comes up. It is a power plant and an office building. So we have to imagine that we convert existing buildings. Now, the existing buildings, you maybe create a little bit of your own power, some of your own power, much of your own power. And the new buildings will create even more power than they need. So, number one, we go to pillar one of the infrastructure, renewable energy. The President Lombardo was committed to Sicily to do that. Number two, we think, as the President said, buildings, 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 we're the power plants. Just like we produce our own information with our desktop computer, we create our own power in our buildings. Some, much, all, more than we need. Then in Brussels, we face problem number three, big problem. How do we store this energy? The sun isn't shining always in Sicily. Even in Sicily, the sun isn't always shining. The wind isn't always blowing here. Your water tables are down during drought. You don't have hydroelectricity. These are intermittent energy. So how do we store them reliably? When Romano Prodi, I've advised Romano for many years, when he was president of the commission, I sat down with him, when he was president of the European Commission, I said, Romano, this was 2003, I said, we got a problem. Because we knew we were going to go to 20% renewables, 33% electricity in Europe, renewables by 2020. And I said, Romano, if we wake up in Europe in 2020, and a third of our electricity is renewable, and it's a hot summer, and there's cloud cover for 2 weeks, no sun, and the wind stops blowing for those 2 weeks across Europe, and the water tables are down for our hydro, what are we doing? And Romano said, that is a good point. So within 3 months, he introduced a 2 billion euro research and development to put hydrogen storage across Europe. We've just introduced a 7 billion euro joint technology initiative to move hydrogen storage. Here's how it works. Hydrogen's the basic element of the universe. All you scientists and engineers know this. The basic element of the universe is the lightest element. When we use hydrogen for power, the only byproducts are pure water, you can drink it, and heat. No carbon. No pollution. No pollution. Our astronauts have been circling this planet, powering their spaceships with high-tech hydrogen fuel cells for 30 years. It is time to bring this technology back to Sicily, back to Italy, back to Europe, out to the world. Here's how it works. You generate electricity in your home in Sicily, or in your factory, or your office. The surplus electricity you don't need, you electrolyze water. Remember high school chemistry? You put the anode, the cathode, in the water, electrify it, and the little hydrogen molecules come out and you store them. Then when you need the electricity, because the sun isn't shining, the hydrogen can convert that in the fuel cell to electricity. That's storage. Number one, first pillar, renewable energy, 20%. Number two, the buildings are converted to suck up all the energies around the buildings. They're distributed. Three, we collect and store it. We store it with hydrogen like we store digital in media. Then pillar four. Pillar four is where the distributed communication revolution converges with the distributed energy revolution to give us a third industrial revolution. We use the same technology that created the internet. It's identical. And we take the power grid of Sicily, the power grid of Italy, the power grid of the EU, the power grid of the world, and we turn it to an intergrid that acts just like the internet. So that when millions of you in Sicily are producing some of your own energy, you can share whatever little you don't need, if the price is right, with everyone else in Sicily across the grid, just like you produce your own information on your computer, store it in digital, share it across the internet.